Hello friends, welcome to JavaScript video tutorial series. From the past few video tutorials, we are trying to understand JavaScript nested loops. In this video tutorial, I would like to discuss how we can display stars in a rows and columns fashion using nested loops. We can display this pattern in many different ways. As we are learning nested loops, I am interested to display the stars in rows and columns fashion using nested loops. So let's get started. I minimize the paint. I right click on default.html, open with the notepad. You can see that default.html is open in the notepad. It has the basic HTML document structure code written. Title is set to JavaScript nested loops demo. Within the body section, we have opening script and closing script tag. I minimize it. I right click on default.html, open with the Google Chrome. You can see that default.html is open in the Chrome. Title is set to JavaScript nested loops demo. I go to notepad. Here I'm going to write for where I is equal to 1, I is less than or equal to 2, I plus plus, opening floor bracket, closing floor bracket. Within that I create one more for loop where j is equal to 1, j is less than or equal to 2, j plus plus, opening floor bracket, closing floor bracket. Here I say document.write display a star. After displaying a star, document.write, you need to push the content down by using the break tag. We know that for every iteration of the outer for loop, the inner for loop is going to get executed 2 times. The outer for loop executes 2 times, the inner for loop executes 2 times, 2 into 2, 4 times these statements will get executed. So we see a star displayed 4 times, one below another. Star, then break, star, then break, star, then break, star, then break, right? File, save, go to browser and refresh. You see, star displayed 4 times, one below another. Actually, we want to display stars in rows and columns fashion, right? Instead of displaying stars one below another, we want to display them in rows and columns fashion. So here we know that after every star, we are pushing the content down, right? Instead of pushing the content down after every star, I just say Control X from here. I put that break tag in the outer for loop. Now what happens? When I is 1, this loop will get executed 2 times. So star will be displayed 2 times, one beside another. There is no break tag, right? So star will be displayed one beside another. Then the break statement will get executed. Then I becomes 2. When I is 2, this loop will get executed 2 times. Again, the star will be displayed 2 times, one beside another. Then the break statement will get executed, right? This time you see star displayed in rows and columns fashion. File, save, go to browser and refresh. See, star displayed one beside another and it is displayed in rows and columns fashion, right? First row, 2 stars, second row, 2 stars. So here you can consider this outer for loop responsible for rows, the inner for loop responsible for columns. What I do here, I create one variable called as rows. I initialize it to 2. I create one more variable called as calls. I initialize it to 2. And here I replace this with rows. And here I replace with calls. 2 rows, 2 columns. File, save, go to browser and refresh. See, we are getting the same output. Let me explain how this code is working. I go to options, more tools, developer tools. You can see that the developer tools is open. I put a breakpoint here and say refresh to pause the execution on line number 10. Now rows is undefined, columns is undefined. Let me say step over. Rows is set to 2, step over, calls is set to 2. We know that outer for loops initialization statement is going to get executed first. I is undefined, you see, I is equal to 1 is going to be assigned. You should see I value set to 1. Now we are checking a condition whether I is less than or equal to rows. I is 1, rows is 2, whether 1 is less than or equal to 2. 1 is less than 2, so any one condition is true, the result is true. As the result is true, the control goes inside. Now the initialization statement of the inner for loop will get executed. J is undefined. I say step over. You should say J is set to 1. We are checking the condition whether J is less than or equal to calls. whether j, k is 1, cols is 2, whether 1 is less than or equal to 2. 1 is less than 2, so the condition is true. Any one condition is true, the result is true. As the condition is true, the control goes inside. Document.write displays a star. See that? And we don't have a break tag there. So the cursor will not be pushed to the next line. It will be on the same line, right? J plus plus. Now the J has become 2. The condition will be checked whether 2 is less than or equal to 2. 2 is not less than 2, but 2 is equal to 2. Any one condition is true, the result is true. As the result is true, the control goes inside. Document.write displays one more star there beside the previous star. Then J plus plus. J will become 3. The condition will be checked whether 3 is less than or equal to 2. 3 is neither less than 2 nor equal to 2, so the result will be false. As the result is false, the control comes outside. Now the break statement will get executed. What the break statement does? It moves the cursor to the next line. It pushes the content to the next line, right? I say step over. Now I plus plus will get executed. I is going to become 2. Now we are checking the condition whether 2 is less than or equal to 2. 2 is not less than 2, but 2 is equal to 2. Any one condition is true, the result is true. As the result is true, control goes inside. Now J will be reinitialized to 1. So I say step over, J is going to become 1. We are checking the condition whether 1 is less than or equal to 2. 1 is less than 2. Any one condition is true, the result is true. Control goes inside. Document.write displays a star on the next line. See that? Then J plus plus. J is going to become 2. Again, the condition will be checked whether 2 is less than or equal to 2. 2 is not less than 2, but 2 is equal to 2. So the condition is true. Any one condition is true, the result is true. Control goes inside. The document.write displays the star. Then J plus plus. Now the J value becomes 3. 3 is less than or equal to 2 we are checking now. 3 is neither less than 2 nor equal to 2. Both conditions are false. The result is false. As the result is false, control comes outside. Document.write breaks the line and I plus plus will get executed. Now the I value becomes 3. We are checking the condition whether 3 is less than or equal to 2. 3 is neither less than 2 nor equal to 2. Both conditions are false. The result is false. As the result is false, the control comes outside. This is how the code is getting executed, friends. So for the first row, 2 stars. For the second row, 2 stars. Right? That's how the code is working. Now we can change the values. I change here 5, 5. 5 rows, 5 columns. File, save, go to browser and refresh. You see 5 rows, 5 columns. For every row, 5 times the star is displayed. Then the break tag has moved the cursor to the next line. That's how the code works. These nested loops are not just used to display some stars. They are used to display a lot of patterns. They are used to solve many problems in games and many other applications. For example, if I want to create a tile map in a game, we use nested loops. If I want to loop through a two-dimensional array or three-dimensional arrays, we take help of these nested loops. Let me show some magics here. Instead of displaying a star, if I display the value of I just use some space here so that a space should be displayed before the I and after the I. So I just put space, then display the value of I and space. File, save, go to browser and refresh. You will see that 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, like 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 4, 4, 4, 4, 5, 5, 5, 5. Like that, the pattern is displayed. You can understand this. It's quite simple. When I is 1, this is executing 5 times. So we are displaying the I value. 1 will be displayed 5 times. Then the break tag will get executed. Content will be pushed to the next line. Next, I becomes 2. This for loop will get executed 5 times. It displays the value of I, that is 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, like that 5 times. Then the break tag will get executed. You can see that how you can display different patterns with the help of nested loops. If I change this I to J, what happens? Can you guess? When I is 1, it displays the value of J here, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 will be displayed. Then the break tag will get executed. Then I becomes 2. This for loop will get executed 5 times. You will see J 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then the break tag will get executed. So you will see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like that displayed one below another. File, save, go to browser and refresh. can see we displayed another pattern. If you really understand these things, you can do a lot of magical things, friends. I hope you guys have clearly understood how nested loop works. I suggest you people to trace the code, understand everything clearly, try yourself something different. I think for this video tutorial, this much is enough, friends. In the next video tutorial, we get more information on nested loops, how they are used. For more benefits and be up to date, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and don't forget to like, comment and share these videos with others so that everyone will get benefited. Keep learning, keep coding, keep sharing. Thank you guys. Thank you very much. See you in the next tutorial.